go away.
His album sales dropped because he handled it like a fool.
No. His album sales dropped. No, because the fact that when that whole situation happened. Okay, what part about the fool that you talking about when you talking about him?
Huh?
What part are you talking about?
I'm talking about after everything happened with Rihanna, and it had already been established. Then he kept going back to the tabloids and pretty much, and
no.
He was sorry.
See, no, that wasn't even the case. He didn't even go back to the tabloids. The tabloids kept coming after him.
But that's
he
what
left
I'm saying.
The thing. No, like, that's not what you just said.
Okay, well, whatever the case, when he talked to the public, he didn't handle it appropriately.
He didn't talk to the public
when
until
the public talked to him.
No,
he didn't handle
the public
it
made their own assumption, and he didn't speak to nobody. They wouldn't let him speak to nobody. He didn't speak to nobody until maybe a year and a half of it, somewhere around there.
Why didn't he issue a public apology?
Why did he issue a public apology?
Why didn't he?
He did.
I don't remember that.
In fact, I believe he did it twice. Of course, some people took it as a please buy my album thing, but yeah. I mean,
I don't remember that.
Well, because you didn't want to see it. Because that wasn't what you was looking for.
No, I wasn't looking for none of it, but from what I see, from what I see just in general.
Which is what? Which is what? Because obviously, you seeing something that nobody else is seeing, because look at them. They disabled their comments. It says it right there. They disabled their comments. So, why do you think they disabled their comments? Why do you think they got a whole bunch of dislikes on there? Because they knew that everyone knew that they fucked up. They know that they fucked up. Look at them.
When you're in public, like, that's why. That's why I would never be a politician.
Right.
Because I can't handle that kind of pressure. I can't have people coming after me, looking at every single little thing that I did wrong, bringing it back up in my face, and being very aggressive about it. I can't handle that.
Right.
That shit would break me down. So I don't choose to be in the public.
Right.
He's in the public's eye. They do that. That's what they do.
Oh, then they got...
That's like people that go on Nancy... That girl that sued Nancy Grace, she was like... Melinda Duckett actually went to school.
Okay, Nancy Grace is a total different subject.
No,
that
not.
Douchebag is like totally
no,
like...
No, but the
seriously.
Fact is, people go on her show. Melinda went on her show. She knew who Nancy Grace was. And if she didn't know, she could have turned
okay,
her
okay, okay, no. Hold on. Okay, so listen. Watch this.
Chris Brown riding high. Brett.
Okay, now first of all, the man did not come here for this. The man, okay, when you go ahead and do stuff like this, the one thing that you do, you already get stuff down packed already. It's not like they say, hey, could you please go ahead on our show? And they say, yeah, sure, why not? No, there is already something set in stone. So he already made mention that he wanted to go ahead and promote his new album. They didn't say, I want to go ahead and talk about Brianna's situation. I want to go ahead and promote my new album. So that's exactly why he was on the show. He went on the show to promote his new album, not to talk about his past.
But he should have known they were going to bring that up. Because why would they want to...
You're right. Totally. He should have realized that these guys have no integrity whatsoever. You're
Usher,
totally right.
Do they have Usher on Good Morning America? Every time he just dropped the album, they had Jamie Foxx on that on Good Morning America.
You know what? They did have Usher on it. Well, not...
For his new album?
Well, when he drops a new album, I don't know. I don't watch Good Morning
America.
That's the
point.
Fuck this show.
That's not the form. Uh-huh. MTV, VH1, all that type of shit is for music. When you go on Good Morning America, that's a different, like... It's a different forum.
So
they don't care about music and shit. They have a couple of people on there talking about the albums and stuff, but that's usually filler. He got prime time spot. And what the fuck did he think it was for? For an album?
That's
prime
true. I gotta go with that. Yeah,
prime,
that's
prime,
true.
Time,
but
prime airtime.
Okay.
He thought it was for an album.
Okay,
really?
So okay. So he was basically doing, right? So the fact that they was already playing against him is what? What exactly are you trying to say here?
That is being a public figure. Even the law makes a distinction between public figures. And like, that's why like on YouTube,
right.
You can't talk about a specific person because that's like cyberbullying.
Uh-huh.
But if you get on there and talk about President Obama or Hillary Clinton or Paris Hilton, those people are fair game. You can talk shit about them all you want to.
Oh, well, I gotta disagree with that. I've been fair game in Pyro for the last couple of days.
He's a private citizen. He's not a public figure. If the law makes a distinction between a public figure and an individual person that's like living and working and just doing regular shit.
Now, at what point does that happen?
Huh?
Where exactly?
There is a line, apparently. It's according
no,
to
no,
the judge.
No, line. The difference is that, well, when it comes to the YouTube form, that when the only reason why their videos don't get removed because those public figures, quite honestly, got a little bit more to do than check YouTube videos.
No,
they kind of get away with it.
Even then, they still have to sue or do take some other action in order for it to get removed and prove.
No, absolutely.
And they have to prove damages. But at the same time, the law...
Actually, you know what? That's kind of not even true either, because YouTube and these other companies have it in place where basically if you already use any form of, like, if I was to take this video right here, to show it on the screen right now, if I was to take this video and post this on my channel, you know what? I would get flagged
instantly.
Yeah,
because it belongs, that's because it's copyrighted by the CBS Corporation.
Right.
Not because you're talking about Robin Williams. I'm talking individual, when you get to an individual, the law, legally.
Legally.
Yes. Oh, statutes.
I'm about to get you. Go ahead. I'm listening.
Makes a distinction between regular, everyday Joe Blows, Joe Sixpack, whatever.
So what you're saying is it was okay for them to be douchebags just because he was a public figure?
I'm just saying, if you can't take the heat, get out the motherfucking kitchen. Whitney Houston's still getting dragged through the mud. And you know what? Her crazy ass can take it.
But you know what? Not one person, because all her recent interviews, I actually seen some recent interviews, not one person dare call, try to go ahead and talk about her past drug addictions.
Yeah, but for a while, that's all they talked about.
Yeah, that's all they talked about, but not to her.
She got blindsided in a couple of interviews, too.
Where?
They would talk about Bobby Brown, they would talk about the crack and cocaine use. Well, she would go, she did that radio interview for her new album, whatever it was. It had some shitty song on it.
I noticed that with Whitney Houston. But anyway.
And then they even badgered her for that. They were like, people are saying that your new album may not be good. And then like, this is a quite a question.
So did you hear it? Did you hear it though? Did you hear the radio, the thing?
What?
The interview.
This one?
No, the other interview.
I heard parts of it.
Okay.
Where they were slamming her.
At what point did she say, well, you know what? I don't want to talk about this no more. I'd rather focus on my new album.
That's what they say.
No, I didn't ask you that. I asked you, what part was it where she said that I don't want to deal with this anymore. I want to go ahead and talk about my new album.
She has said that a lot of times in her interviews. She's like, well, this interview is about me and my new beginning. It's not about me and what goes on in my house, or it's not about me.
And do they continue?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Because I have not seen no one do it yet.
I've seen plenty of people do it. And they're like, well, Whitney, you made that show with you and Bobby Brown, and it's obvious that you don't mind sharing it with the world, so why not share it here? I've heard people actually ask her that. So it's like,
well, no, technically yes.
He can't
take the heat. Okay.
That young man can't take the heat. He need to get out the motherfucking kitchen.
Well, no. He was, no. Gay was a douchebag. They should never have, no, first of all.
Like, that's the first time the media's been a douchebag to somebody?
No, it's not. But that doesn't make it any better.
That's the difference between one level of being a celebrity and the next level. Because people ask them hard questions. People are douchebags.
So by that logic, you're saying, okay, well, I can go ahead and have a one-on-one conversation. And even though I told this guy, you know, I told Obama that we were going to talk about how good his family is, I can go ahead and just bring up all kinds of things and how, you know, people are saying how
president
you,
too.
I'm not saying that. I'm saying that you're saying that that's okay.
I'm saying that that is the standard. And he can't even live up to what is the standard in
Well, I tell you what. I tell you what. If that's the fact, I tell you what. Didn't Vanilla Ice and many other people went in there and went hell on what do you call them things? Whatever he destroyed and all that. So, hey, they deserve what they got, right? Because that's the standard. Because when they do these things, most of the people out there, they go ahead and trash the dressing rooms or trash the store. Because that's okay then. They're both okay. So, you know, there's no need to have this conversation.
I'm just saying.
Because it's okay to trash a dressing room because of the fact that they talk about it. It obviously is because that's an industry standard, because that's something that happens when
they
do that.
And they ask these tough questions. They act like douchebags. That's what the media does. That's why they make that distinction, because they know the media is douchebags, and they don't usually let people in regular situations get that kind of abuse.
Right.
They allow public figures to get that kind of abuse because they think they can stand up to the pressure. And then when it does happen, they usually trash the dressing room. Right?
That's not why. Most likely case is because they know they're in the public eye.
But
so it's like kind of getting away with it.
Job. They get paid millions and millions of dollars, and it's part of their fucking job. That's like when you go to work, if you didn't want to take no phone calls. What the fuck are you there for?
You're there
to be in the public eye. You're there to be a character. It's almost like a never-ending play or never-ending part in a movie. You're a character.
Right.
Everyone's always got, it's just like being in a movie. Everyone's got their eye on the screen. Their eye is on you.
Uh-huh.
They're going to do that.
Right.
They watch everything.
So like I said, then, it's fine then.
The media acts like a douchebag. Uh-huh. The artist or the celebrity acts like a douchebag.
Uh-huh.
The public reacts to both of those instances how they see fit.
Now, granted that, I'm not going to say that Chris Brown really didn't need to do that. Like, that was the last thing he needed to do. I understand. But it wasn't,
like,
but go ahead.
People have been accused of, like, doing drugs.
Uh-huh.
You trashed your dressing room? Okay, maybe it was hot. He's been accused of physically harming someone in a fit of anger.
No, that's what I'm saying. He shouldn't have done it. Yeah, that was like...
That's what the public's reacting to. Like, oh, yeah, he beat him. Now we know he beat him.
Because
he can't control himself. Even though there's plenty of people that can't control themselves.
Real talk. But I'm saying...
It's just like he proved a point. That's why people are reacting the way they are. It's like because he was accused of something related to what he did.
Oh, no, I understand that. I understand that completely.
Why not? The media, you cannot blame the media in this situation because they did. It's status quo.
I'm not blaming him. I'm not blaming the media for what Chris Brown did. What Chris Brown does is what Chris Brown does, and that's Chris Brown's. He has to take responsibility for that. That's that. But at the same time, what they do is what they do, and they need to take responsibility for what they do.
For what? Doing their job. They provoke people. They ask questions that douchebag viewers want to hear. And it's not even the media that's a douchebag. Because if the media, only does what gets them views and what gets them ratings. It's kind of like you do on YouTube.
Uh-huh.
If people didn't care about all that drama between you and Pyro and all that type of stuff, would you really give a fuck about that dude?
Can't argue with that.
It's like, she was asking the questions that the viewers want to hear. Uh-huh. If they didn't ask those questions, then who would watch it?
Right.
And who would be, I mean, who is he really, you know, out there in front of if no one's watching?
Wait, what do you mean? What do you mean exactly? Because I got to respond, but I want to make sure I understand what you're saying.
Okay, he went on Good Morning America.
To promote his album.
To reach an audience.
To promote it? Okay, yeah, right. Promote the same thing, yeah.
That's not the same thing.
How's that the same thing?
Because I'm saying in general, that's narrow. I'm talking about in general, he went to reach an audience. Okay. That's why you go interact with the media.
Okay, I hear you. I hear you. Go ahead.
Now, do you think people would watch the media, Good Morning America, all these different talk shows, if people did not have an interest in what was going to be presented to them? I know I don't watch shit that's not interesting to me.
Okay.
And they have that interest because they deal with controversial topics.
So long and short of it, basically, you're saying that they pretty much just drug his past a little bit through the mud there for ratings. And that's supposed to be okay because it's an industry standard?
Like I said, why do you think he was getting primetime billing on Good Morning America?
Did he really get primetime billing? I don't know what he got, actually.
Good Morning America only comes on at a certain time of the day.
I'm assuming in the morning, but...
And they only have a very few topics. They deal with international news. They deal with, like, you know, breaking news, health. They have topics
that
they deal with. He was lucky enough to get into one of those spots.
How was he lucky enough?
Not lucky enough, but that's good airtime.
Okay.
He ain't on, he's not on in the middle of the night. He's not on stuck between some MTV shows or something. That is...
MTVs don't have shows.
I don't know.
Do you want to classify them as shows?
I don't know. I'm saying this is a huge audience that he got.
Right. Now, I'm not saying that that part you're not wrong with.
But then what did he think was going... They don't do that for promoting record. That's not what Good Morning America is about.
Right.
That's not what they do.
Well,
they don't give a fuck who album is dropping this week. They don't have Mike Jones on there.
Because Mike Jones ain't dropping no albums. Last time Mike Jones dropped an album? When the last time Mike Jones even alive?
He do the auto-tune stuff in there.
I don't even know anymore.
No, that's T-Pain. He have T-Pain on there.
I got hot. See, look at that.
But that's not because he was dropping an album. That's because he's like made a sensation out of this whole auto-tune thing that's like sweeping genres and generations and all kinds of stuff.
I can get the T-Pain, like, the whole thing. I mean, Blackstreet was doing auto-tuning on their album way before T-Pain.
But it's all about the marketing. There's a whole bunch of companies that did shit before other people did it, but...
Yeah.
You know. But at the end of the day, Good Morning America...
It's douchebags, exactly. I totally agree,
it's
girl.
It's about people, celebrities, topics that make a change, that make a difference, and that people are really, really interested in.
Okay.
They don't do that type of stuff.
Okay, so...
They don't do album promotions.
Okay, so basically, in the end, what you're saying is... It's kind of Chris Brown should have realized what he was getting into.
I'm just saying that if you can't take the heat, because that's part of the job. Charlie Sheen is getting bit in the asshole right now, and he's just going along with the ride. He was like, you know what? I am crazy. I smoke crack. I fuck hookers. I got kids, and they being there with me.
And me being Zephyrnix, I can't even argue with that particular logic because I do that shit every day. I feed off that shit. I love that shit.
And then you can deny it. I mean, there's a lot of techniques you can take. You can just deny it to the day you die, even though you're sitting there with a crack rock in your hand. Everybody can tell you how it went, Houston.
Nah, why you dropping names? Why you doing that? That's wrong. That's wrong. Why you dropping Whitney's name? Come on now. Come on, girl. Be good, girl.
But it's like...
Now I hear you. I hear you. I get
you.
You
know what I mean?
I mean, yeah,
and
I get you.
Can't take the heat. That's the problem. I'm not going to sit up there and try to be no celebrity. I'm not going to try to be known.
In that case, I need to be a celebrity, though, because they can't do shit to me.
Because I just can't take it.
Yeah, you're right.
I mean, I was just watching a Charlie Sheen interview, and the lady was asking him, she's like, well, you know, what about your kids? Basically, she's saying, you're a fucked up parent, and you got these two hookers in here staying with you, being nannies to your kids, and y'all in here smoking crack and stuff. I don't know about all this. And you know, he was like, well, it's rock and roll lifestyle. Damn, Charlie.
He said, damn, Charlie.
It was like, you know what I'm saying? All
right, come on. It's time to go. I got to get ready for, I got to get dressed and shit.
Come on, can't even do his job. He's going to be fired. That's what he needs to do. He's going to be fired.
He needs to be fired? Yeah. All right.